Today is a day that conceptualized my dream coming to fruition. I entered this set as a humble servant of God, and I realized that I was meeting a perfect stranger, and that stranger lived on the inside of me. And since that day, I have not been the same. Journey with me as I transform my mind. I love you. Be blessed. Enjoy. There is no way I can stop loving God.
What is transforming your mind?
Transform your mind came about when I was given the challenge to look at my own life and to realize that my age, what opportunities I had forfeited, and where did I want to be forthcoming.
Okay.
So I looked at my profession and I saw individuals that needed the opportunity to transform some things. So what I did, I piloted myself by going back and looking at my past and saying, what can I do about those opportunities that either I missed or I forfeited? And then I started to make a change in order to go back and help someone else. So I'm opening up my journey on YouTube at Transform Your Mind with Pam Ryan to give people the opportunity to have a resource in the community to hold their hand while they make different choices to reposition themselves for their future.
That is so interesting, because because look at the sensations that come out of YouTube.
Right.
Smart move. Right.
And I wanted to use YouTube as a venture because I have a lot of individuals that sometimes need to see your face. I'm texting every morning at about 5 to over 100, 130 people, just giving them that push, that motivation to go get it, believe in yourselves. You know, what we have is already in us to believe, to go get it. So then I say, well, let me put a face with that. Let me show you that I am serious. So I dare to go on YouTube, and with technology being the way it is, it was a challenge. But co-workers helped me, and I'm there. I'm trying to get there every Monday, Wednesday. On Friday, I have the unique opportunity of presenting my alter ego. Her name is Ryan Clark.
Okay.
And she tells you what I did in the meantime.
Oh.
So not only was I praying, not only was I reading my Bible, I was listening to various things. I was reading, I was writing. I produced 4 books, in which I'm very proud of, where I talk about how I transitioned, because that's what I did in the meantime. And sometimes we need something else to do, whether it's polish your nails, read, maybe garden. You know, what else are you going to do as you go back and alter your focus?
Like a lot of what Philip said, too, earlier,
right.
This is so much about personal responsibility.
Right. And sometimes, in life,
you wallow in your past
right.
and do something about it.
But I believe that we have to go back and embrace our past, even if it is flawed. Let's understand that it may be flawed by things that happen beyond our control. So can I say, yes, I was a victim of this situation, but I'm not going to allow that situation to go forth with me. And that's one of my positions is, my program is called the STOP program. And what I did was I just stopped everything. I stopped wearing makeup. I didn't shop. I just stopped. And then I went back and just started dealing with some childhood issues.
Okay.
Saying, okay, let me lay this to rest. Let me lay that to rest. And then I replaced it with facts. The facts that Jesus said, I will never leave nor forsake you. So if I put that into place, he will never leave nor forsake me, then I'm able to look at a situation and transform it. My coworker said the other day that her air conditioner went out in her car. So I said, why don't you transform your mind on that? She's looking to, shed a few pounds. So I said, why don't you look at your air conditioner going out as the opportunity for a sign? So just drink a lot of water, ride around in town, and that is your personal sign.
I like that.
That's clever. Exactly. So why don't we just transform the way we see things?
But you wouldn't have to go pay, go to a spa,
exactly.
Use a sign.
Just use that until you're able to get your car repaired. This is my sign.
I like it. It's very clever.
Yeah. And so that's what I'm asking people, to just think about things on the positive. If you're able to accept the fact that Jesus Christ is for us and not against us, then every course in our life is setting us up for success.
What did she say?
Laughed. She said, I had to think about that.
I bet you're probably gonna, she didn't know what to say.
No, I usually catch people off guard.
Yeah. That's funny. That's pretty clever. Maybe she'll take your advice.
Yes.
But at least you gave her some food for thought.
I did.
Now you can Facebook you?
I'm at Facebook on Pamela.Ryans.
And?
I'm on Twitter at TransformPam. My Gmail is transformpam@gmail.com. And my personal number, because I don't mind being personal.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm opening up, my number is 205-657-6486.
Okay. And now, how do you follow on YouTube?
On YouTube, I am at Transform Pam. So you can go to YouTube, put in Transforming Your Mind with Pam Ryans, and you'll be able to see, and I have about 21 videos up.
Okay.
And I tell people, you know, that we need to accept apology, we need to forgive, we need to be patient, you know, we can just ask, you know, and the thing that I like is I'm able to go on Facebook and I view so many lives, and people have issues. One of my friends has MS, one of my friends has cancer, and I call them personally and I say, will you allow me to walk through this with you? So I text them each morning, no, let's go, let's get it.
Even when I'm on my own.
That's the way it is with technology. I know it was cut short, but I hope you enjoyed my journey. This is only the beginning. These are my reasons to shine. Today I'm featuring Kim and Lettucey. I hope you enjoy. So transform your mind. Transform the way you see things, especially yourself, especially God. Have a great day.
By my side, just like this, yeah. When everybody else had doubts, you held me down, just like you said you.